Hi friends, welcome back to Leap and ICSE Learning Channel. It is difficult to imagine how mathematical principles are used in real life. Ratio is a perfect example of maths in real life. Today I am going to explain the application of ratios in real life. Application of ratio. The ratio of tin and zinc in an alloy is 3:4. In 21 gram of alloy, find the quantity of tin and zinc. So first we have to write down the given data. So ratio of tin and zinc. Ratio of tin and zinc is equal to 3:4. So what is the meaning of this? That is, this is the relationship between tin and zinc in that particular alloy. That is, if total 7 gram of alloy is there, in that alloy 3 gram of tin is present and 4 gram of zinc is present. So sum of the ratio Sum of the ratio 3+4 equal to 7. That is, in 7 gram of alloy, the quantity of tin present is 3 gram. So 1 gram of alloy, what is the quantity of tin present? So 1 gram of alloy, quantity of tin present equal to 3/7. So 1 gram of alloy, quantity of zinc present is equal to 4/7 gram. But here we have to find out, in 21 gram of alloy, find the quantity of tin and zinc. So in 21 gram, quantity of tin in 1 gram of the alloy, quantity of tin present is 3/7 gram. So in 21 gram, the quantity of tin present is 3/7 into 21. That is 3. So 3 into 3, 9 gram. Then in 1 gram of alloy, the quantity of zinc present is 4/7 gram. So in 21 gram, quantity of zinc present is equal to 4/7 into 21. So 4 into 3, 12 gram. Next question. A certain recipe calls for 3 kg of sugar for every 6 kg of flour. If 60 kg of this wheat has to be prepared, how much sugar is required? See, to create dish with good flavor, consistency and texture, the various ingredients must have a kind of relationship between them. That is, ingredients have relationship between them is an important concept in cooking. This relationship between the ingredients, in mathematics, this relationship is known as ratio. Solution. Ratio of sugar and flour equal to 3:6. What is the meaning of this? If 9 kg of this particular sweet contains 3 kg of sugar and 6 kg of flour, So sum of ratios is equal to 3 plus 6 is equal to 9. So in 9 kilogram of this particular sweet contains 3 kilogram of sugar and 6 kilogram of flour. So quantity of sugar present in 1 kilogram. Quantity of sugar present in 1 kilogram, it is equal to 3 by 9. So quantity of flour present in 1 kilogram, quantity of flour present in 1 kilogram is equal to 6 by 9. Now we have to find out the quantity of sugar in 60 kilogram of this sweet. So quantity of sugar present in 60 kilogram quantity of sugar in 60 kilogram. For 1 kilogram, quantity of sugar is 3 by 9. So, in 60 kilogram, it is 3 by 9 into 60. That is 3, then 20. So, it is 20 kilogram. Then, quantity of flour present in 60 kilogram. Quantity of flour in 60 kilogram. In 1 kilogram, quantity of sugar is 6 by 9. So quantity of flour in 60 kilogram is 6 by 9 into 60. So this will become 40 kilograms.
Keep on watching my channel. If you like this video, please subscribe it and share it.